वेलकम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू चैप्टर 10 द ऑल अमेरिकन स्लर. सो देयर आर इन दिस चैप्टर देयर आर टू फैमिलीज. फर्स्ट वन इज ए अमेरिकन फैमिली द ग्लीसंस एंड सेकेंड वन इज अ चाइनीज फैमिली द लिन्स. द चाइनीज फैमिली इट मीन्स द लिन्स आर मिग्रेटेड फ्रॉम चाइना टू अमेरिका. मिग्रेट मतलब मिग्रेट मीन्स leaving a country and set up in another country. So the Chinese family, the Lins, are migrated from China to America. In their early days in America, they have to face so many problems. They have to learn American table manners. One day, they are invited at a dinner party at the home of Gleason's. In China, they never eat raw vegetables. And celery, they are always used to first of all boil all the raw vegetables and then they eat that. But when they go to the American dinner party, first of all a relish tray is presented in front of them. The relish tray has pickles, olives, celery sticks. And some radish and carrot. Mrs. Gleason offered the relish tray and tell Mrs. Lin to try some celery that they had brought from a local farmer. Mother, yani the Lin's, Mrs. Lin picked up one celery and the Mr. Lin is also done that. In Chinese family, there are the four members, Mr. and Mrs. Lin and their daughter Gi and their son. And in American family, there are three persons, Mr. and Mrs. Gleason and their daughter Mac. So Mrs. all the four members of the Chinese family, they pick up a stalks of celery in their right hand. Then Mrs. Gleason offered a dip to them, but the Chinese don't like dairy products, so they decline the offer. They all are sitting there and watching at other guests what they are doing with celery stalks, because for the Chinese family it looked like unprepared because they never eat raw celeries. But mother took a bite of her celery. Crunch, it is not too bad, she whispered. And father took a bite of celery too. Crunch, yes, it is too good, she said, looking surprised. Me and my brother are also taking a bite of that stalks of celery. That was delicious. Again, Mrs. Gleason come around with them, and they all four again took a celery stalks. Except her brother, he took two celery stalks. But the main problem was eating with celery stalks, that there was a long string that ran through the length of the celery stalks. And Gi start pulling out the strings with the sound zip. Mother, father and brother followed the same. Suddenly, the Gi realized that there was a dead silence in the room and everyone was staring at them because they are busy to pull their strings from their celery stalks. That was an embarrassing moment for the Chinese family. Mrs. Gleason announced that the dinner was served and invited them to dining table. The Gi said that the dinner was so good, all the plates there were the lavishly covered with platters of food. But we cannot find any chair around the table. So helpfully, we are arranging some chairs and sat down. And the other guests of the American families are standing and stood up there. Then again, Mrs. Gleason come to us and said that it is a buffet dinner. Buffet dinner means a dinner in which we have to serve ourselves and sit down. And you can take your dinner in the living room. That was again an embarrassing moment for the Chinese family. First of all, when they are pulling out the string from their celery stalk, and the second part, then they are arranged some chair around the table because that was a buffet dinner. So we have to take the dinner in our plates and take them dinner by stood up or by sitting in the living area. So there are the two embarrassing moments for the Chinese persons, Chinese family members in that dinner. Next day, Meg and Gi, who are the friends, they are got on the school bus together. Gi was so afraid ki what was the Meg feel about her and her family members after the dinner party. But Meg was as usual behave as she has done with the Gi in the daily basis. And she tell that hope you and your family members got the enough to eat the last night because you are not taking so much. And my mom, and then Meg told to Gi that my mom was hoping for the best and she never thinking about how much food she has to prepare for the dinner. She put everything on the table. Then Gi begin to relax and Gi think that ki the American table manners or American dinner parties are not so different from a Chinese meal because her mother was also doing the hope for the best and put everything on the table. So this is the first part of the chapter. There are the two part of the chapter. First one, when the Chinese families are invited to the dinner party at American house, what I already explained to you. And now the second part is when the Chinese are also arranged a dinner party for Americans. In the next part of the video, I am going to explain that. So I hope you understand that and this video is so helpful to understand the chapter. Now we will meet again with the next part.